lie to you folks. We told you we had living, breathing monstrosities. You laughed at them, shuddered at them, and yet, but for the accident of birth, you might be even as they are. They did not ask to be brought into the world, but into the world they came.
And now, folks, if you'll just step this way, you are about to witness the most amazing, the most astounding, living monstrosity of all time. Welcome back to Dave's Creative Cave, where for the next 8 minutes, I will be your host, Dave Thornton. And this is my movie review of the film Freaks from 1932. So where do I begin? This movie was so disturbing, it gave me nightmares. No, not really, but it did give me the heebie-jeebies.
They give you rabies, you know.
Yes, quack, I see your point.
Something about these characters with their deformities. Now, I'm pretty much desensitized to all scary movie types, for I grew up traumatized as a young kid from the likes of such films as all the Nightmare on Elm Streets, all the Halloweens, all the Friday the 13th, and the worst one of all, Stephen King's It.
Aren't you gonna say hello?
So back in 1932, people really hadn't experienced horror in the movies yet. So this movie caused a lot of unpleasantries for the audience. It did so much that the director who made the film, Todd Browning, his career was pretty much over after receiving public backlash for such an attack on morality by portraying people with disabilities as some sort of monstrous beings. Even after the successful making of Dracula, which pretty much made him a star, his career never recovered. It is even said that this film was an attack on MGM and Louis Mayer, the founder of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, or MGM Studios, and that the circus was a sort of distorted image of Hollywood. So much like the circus exploiting its freaks for profit, Hollywood was doing the same with its actors. Now, Mayer hated this film so much, he did not fight the ban that was placed on this film, which kept this movie out of viewing audiences for over 30 years. The stars of this movie, most of which had real deformities, include Johnny Eck as the half-boy. Yes, he was really a half-man born with a truncated torso. Frances O'Connor, who played the armless girl. She really had no arms and was seen eating with her feet in the movie. Then there was Schlitz, who played Pinhead. He suffered from retardation. Then there was Josephine Joseph, who played the half-man, half-woman, who was a real-life hermaphrodite, that is, having both male and female reproductive parts. The Siamese twins, played by Violet and Daisy Hamilton, they were really conjoined twins. And then Prince Randian, who played the Snake Man, otherwise known as the Living Torso, or the Caterpillar Man. He was most noted for his ability to roll and light cigarettes with the only thing he had, his lips. Then there were the quote-unquote normal actors, Wallace Ford as Forso, Henry Victor as Hercules, Olga Baklanova as the sexy Cleopatra. Not my book, she wasn't. And Lila Hayams as Venus. The story starts out with an enticing enigma. What's in the box? As a crowd gathers around a pen, peering down at the latest sideshow novelty. All we are left to be known is that she was once a beautiful woman, and the contents of the box remain hidden from view until the end of the movie, which starts off as a drama between lovers and later includes a love triangle between two freaks and a normal woman. Han, the handsome dwarf, his girlfriend Freda, who was also a real-life dwarf, and Cleopatra, the trapeze artist, who Hans had the hots for. At first, Hans and Cleopatra's affair starts out as a joke to mock him, until she learns he holds a valuable fortune. Then the two get married, and Cleopatra poisons Han in an attempt to kill him so she can inherit his money. When the other freaks learn of this, they become outraged and decide to take up revenge against the trapezist, which results in a bizarre and twisted ending. This film was a little intriguing to me because I did want to know what was in that box. I did not feel that this was a horror movie. Although uniquely disturbing, it's more a tragic drama. It creeped me out, especially after I learned about the freaks having real-life deformities. And it kind of reminded me of the Oompa Loompas from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Oompa Loompa, doompa-dee-da. If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too, like the Oompa Loompa, doompa-dee-doo.
From a morality standpoint, I feel it was wrong of the studio for exploiting these handicapped persons, as well as the director and anyone else who was involved with this production, in order to obtain a few bucks. Actually, this movie only grossed just over $4,000. That's because this film was blacklisted almost out the gate. This film was entertaining for me in a bizarre Alfred Hitchcock enters the Twilight Zone sort of way, and I would recommend watching this film for at least once, just for the experience. This concludes my review of the film Freaks from 1932. Thank you. How she got that way will never be known. Some say a jealous lover, others say it was the code of the freaks. Some, the storm. Believe it or not, there she is.